Hello everyone. In the last video, we have seen functionals depending on functions of several variables. And in particular, we have derived the Ostrogradsky equation for the functionals depending on functions of two variables. Okay, we have considered the notation where z is a function which is depending on two variables, independent variables x and y. Okay, now let us look at one example based on this Ostrogradsky equation. Vz x comma y equal to differentiating z with respect to x the whole square plus differentiating z with respect to y the whole square dx dy. Okay, note that this can also be written as this d p square plus q square dx dy. Okay, because I have already mentioned to you in the last video that we will be referring to this quantity as p and this as q, that is differentiating z with respect to x as p and differentiating z with respect to y as q. So the extremal is given by the Ostrogradsky equation, which is minus differentiating with respect to y this f of q. Okay, so capital F is of the form p square plus q square, differentiating f with respect to z is equal to 0, differentiating f with respect to p is 2p, differentiating f with respect to q is equal to 2 into q. Now we substitute all these quantities here. So what we will get is this equal to 0. Okay, so whatever is the extremal curve of surface, it should satisfy the Ostrogradsky equation. Okay, so we start with this equation and we try to solve it. So this will be differentiating with respect to x 2p minus differentiating with respect to y 2q equal to 0. Okay, so this will be with respect to x plus differentiating this z with respect to y. Okay, because see here, this 2 is a constant, minus sign we can take it common out, so it will get cancelled, and then dou by dou x of p. But what is p? P is dou by dou x of z. So it's the second derivative, second partial derivative of z with respect to x. Okay, so which is written like this: dou square z by dou x square plus dou square z by dou y square, and this is equal to 0. Okay, this is a second order partial differential equation, and it is a special equation. It has a name, it's called as Laplace equation. Okay, so minimizer of this, okay, so whatever, so in general I can say the extremizer of this will be a solution of this Laplace equation. Okay, now for this topic we will not be solving this partial differential equation. Okay, like for example, in Euler-Lagrange equation, we were going ahead of this and we were finding the solution what it is. Okay, because differential equations is what we already know to solve, but partial differential equations, this we have not dealt with before. Okay, so here in this part of the topic, what we will be doing is we will just derive from the Ostrogradsky equation, we will just simplify it and come to the partial differential equation, whatever it is. So whatever the solution is or the extremal is of this given functional, it will be the solution of this Laplace's equation, or in general you can say partial differential equation. Okay, it can be solved. Okay, and in this case the problem dealing which is related to this equation, it has a name in partial differential equation, okay, and it's called as the Dirichlet problem. And the specialty of that problem is it takes some specific values on the boundary of the domain D, okay, and then we solve with that condition, we solve this equation. If you notice, that's the same boundary condition that we require in such type of functionals, okay, and then we try to find out that function z x comma y, okay, which is called as the solution of the Laplace's equation, okay, and that problem in partial differential equation, it's called as Dirichlet's problem. For now, only deriving this equation till here is enough for us. Okay. Let us look at one more example. V z x comma y equal to p square plus q square plus 2z f x comma y dx dy. Okay, the extremal is given by the Ostrogradsky equation, and for that we will need f, that is p square plus q square plus 2z f x y. Differentiating f with respect to z is equal to 2 into f. Differentiating f with respect to p is 2p. Differentiating f with respect to q is 2q, okay, and therefore the Ostrogradsky equation, which is fz minus dou by dou x of fp minus dou by dou y of fq equal to 0, this will take the form 2f minus differentiating with respect to x 2p minus differentiating with respect to y 2q equal to 0. Okay, so if we simplify this, 2f I can keep it here, and then if we take this on the other side, it will be dou square dou x square of z plus dou square z by dou y square is equal to, that 2 will get cancelled with this, and what we will get is, I just put it here, so we will get f x comma y is equal to dou square z by dou x square plus dou square z by dou y square. Okay, and this is a second order partial differential equation. Okay, see, we are differentiating z twice with respect to x. Okay, so it becomes a second order partial differential equation. Again, this partial differential equation is also a special one, and it has a name. It's called as the Poisson's equation. Okay, so we will not get into finding the solution of this partial differential equation. Okay, what we will do is we will just derive this equation and keep it as it is. So whatever is the extremal, it will be the solution of this equation. Okay, let us look at one more example. V z x comma y is equal to root of वन प्लस पी स्क्वेयर प्लस क्यू स्क्वेयर डी एक्स डी वाई. ओके, वी वॉन्ट टू टेस्ट दिस एक्सट्रीमल फॉर दिस फंक्शनल फॉर मिनिमम. ओके, सो द ऑस्ट्रोग्रेट्स की इक्वेशन फॉर दिस विल बी गिवन बाय माइनस डू बाय डू एक्स ऑफ एफ पी माइनस डू बाय डू वाई ऑफ एफ क्यू इक्वल टू ज़ीरो. ओके, सो डिफरेंशिएटिंग एफ विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू जेड इज इक्वल टू ज़ीरो. डिफरेंशिएटिंग एफ विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू पी इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन टू रूट ऑफ वन प्लस पी स्क्वेयर प्लस क्यू स्क्वेयर इंटू टू पी. सो दिस इज इक्वल टू पी अपॉन रूट ऑफ वन प्लस पी स्क्वेयर प्लस क्यू स्क्वेयर. एंड डिफरेंशिएटिंग एफ विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू क्यू विल बी वन अपॉन टू रूट ऑफ वन प्लस पी स्क्वेयर क्यू स्क्वेयर इंटू टू क्यू. सो दिस इज इक्वल टू क्यू डिवाइडेड बाय रूट ऑफ वन प्लस पी स्क्वेयर प्लस क्यू स्क्वेयर. एंड देयरफॉर दिस ऑस्ट्रोग्रेट्स की इक्वेशन इट विल गेट द फॉर्म ओके डू बाय डू एक्स ऑफ p divided by root of 1 plus p square plus q square minus dou by dou y of q root of 1 plus p square plus q square equal to 0. Okay, the minus sign will vanish and we will be left with dou by dou x of p divided by root of 1 plus p square plus q square plus dou by dou y of q divided by root of 1 plus p square plus q square equal to 0. Okay, see here we can still simplify this equation by differentiating this term with respect to x, partially with respect to x, and differentiating this term partially with respect to y. So what we will get is, when we want to differentiate this partially with respect to x, so it's u upon v form. So it will be differentiating this with respect to x, so that is d square z by dx square. Okay, because this is already zx and I am again differentiating this with respect to x, so it will be differentiate, it will be actually zxx. Okay, so which we write it like this, into this, so that is root of 1 plus p square plus q square minus p as it is into derivative of this. Derivative of this will be partial derivative of this with respect to x, so it will be 1 upon 2 times root of 1 plus p square plus q square into derivative of whatever is inside this root sign, so derivative of that with respect to x, so it will be 2p into derivative of p with respect to x, so that is this. Okay, so it will be dou square z by dou x square plus 2 into q into derivative of q with respect to x, so that will be of this form. Okay, so differentiating it with respect to z with respect to y. Okay, because q is what, q is zy and we are differentiating it with respect to x, so it will be dou z dou x dou y. Okay, so it will be this term divided by this full term divided by this, and then this full thing divided by square of this v, so that is 1 plus p square plus q square. Okay, plus we want to differentiate this with respect to y, so what it will be, differentiating this with respect to y into whatever is this minus, keeping this as it is, into derivative of this with respect to y divided by this square, which is equal to this. Okay, so that term will be again this is z y. Okay, so again differentiating it with respect to y will be z y y, so that we write it as z y square into root of 1 plus p square plus q square. Okay, minus, keep this as it is, q into derivative of this with respect to y, so that will be 1 upon 2 times root of 1 plus p square plus q square into 2p, and differentiating p with respect to y. Okay, p is zx, so differentiating this with respect to y, so that will be differentiating it with respect to y. Okay, plus 2q into differentiating q with respect to y, so that will be again this term. Okay, so this 2 can be taken common out, it will get cancelled with this. Okay, and we will get some simplified term in the numerator. This full thing divided by 1 plus p square plus q square. Okay, so now what do we have? This term plus this term. Okay, so when you simplify this, you will observe that it is equal to this square into 1 plus q square minus 2pq into this y, okay, plus dou square z by dou y square into 1 plus p square, okay, equal to 0. So I leave this to you all, simplifying it. It's just the algebraic work now. What you have to do is multiply this into this. Okay, so this term will become 1 plus p square plus q square. Okay, and then you take this in the denominator. But before that, cancel out these two by taking common term. Okay, and then you simplify. You will observe that the denominators are same in both the places. So you directly add the numerators and simplify the term. You will get this equation equal to 0. Okay, and whatever is our required extremal surface, that will be that must be a solution of this second order partial differential equation. Okay, now till now we have seen in particular z is a function of x comma y. Okay, now let us look at if what happens if z is of this form x2 x3 till xn. So capital F is will be of the form x1 x2 till xn, okay, and this z and p1 p2 till pn dx1 dx2 till dxn. Okay, where note that this pi is differentiating z with respect to xi. Okay, from the basic necessary condition for an extremum, that is this delta v equal to 0. This is the necessary condition for the extremum of a functional. Okay, what we get is the Ostrogradsky equation, which is of the form differentiating f with respect to z minus summation I going from 1 till n. Okay, and partially differentiating it with respect to xi, and this capital F with pi equal to 0. Okay, so in particular, if you see, if I is equal to 2, sorry, n is equal to 2, then what will this be? It will be f of z minus summation I going from 1 to 2. Okay, partially differentiating it this, and f with p I, that is equal to 0. So we will get f of z minus differentiating with respect to f1 p1 minus partial differentiating with respect to f p2 is equal to 0. Okay, where what is p1 and p2? P1 is differentiating z with respect to the first variable x1, and p2 is differentiating z with respect to the second variable, that is x2. Okay, now in particular what we have done is x1 we have taken it as x and x2 we took it as y. Okay, so what is this? This is zx and this is zy. Okay, and we have called this as q and this as p. Okay, so this becomes f of p. So p1 is p in our case and p2 is q. Okay, so this becomes f p minus dou by dou y of, this will be x and x2 will be y, f of q. Okay, so in general if we want to talk, what we do is we say 1 2 3 till n. Okay, so for n variable the Ostrogradsky equation will be given by this formula, where pi is the partial derivative of z with respect to the ith variable. Okay, and what is this? It is partial derivative of capital F with respect to the pi. So in this case this is the equation which the function z x1 x2 till xn must satisfy. Okay, so whatever is that function z x1 x2 till xn which is extremizing the functional v, it must satisfy this equation. Okay, then there will be one more type of functional where z x comma y it is equal to capital F x y z, then differentiating z with respect to x, differentiating z with respect to y, then double differentiating meaning second partial derivative of z with respect to x, second partial derivative of z with respect to y, and mixed partial derivative. Okay, and dx dy. If the functional is of this type, then what we get is minus dou by dou x of fp minus dou by dou y of fq plus dou square dou x dou y of capital F of s. I will define what is this f of s. Okay, and plus this dou square dou x square of this capital F of r plus dou square dou y square of capital F of this t equal to 0. Okay, students note here, I should have written this term first and then second this term. Okay, so this term, this then this term, and then here it is. Okay, so then r s t, we can define it nicely. So let me define what is this f of s, f r and s. Okay, so p is equal to differentiating z with respect to x, q is differentiating z with respect to y. Okay, and r is differentiating this z with respect to x, s is differentiating z with respect to x and then with respect to y. Okay, so when we differentiate z with respect to x and then with respect to y, or maybe differentiating z with respect to y and then with respect to x, here we consider the two mixed partial derivatives to be equal. Okay, so this term, it is mixed partial derivative term, that is z s, and t is equal to this. Okay, so see here, capital F will have the term this, this as well as this. Okay, so like it was having the term PQ, it will also have the term RST, and therefore these are well defined. That means we can very well differentiate the capital F partially with respect to X, and we can also differentiate capital F partially with respect to R. We can also differentiate capital F partially with respect to T. In the same way, like how we were differentiating capital F partially with respect to P. Okay, because this functional is of this type, S, R, S, and T will be also present in that functional. Okay.